celebrating the solemnity of All Saints. Please join us in our entrance song, He is Exalted.
Brothers and sisters, as we reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you, falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to
you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let's sing. Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Okay, up to there. I just want to wake you up. Why? Because we really have a reason to be happy today. It's the solemnity of All Saints. And All Saints right now are enjoying their eternal life with all the angels and with our Heavenly Father Jesus Christ in heaven. And it reminds us also that each of us are called to be saints. Oh, we are all called to be saints. We are all called to be holy. To be holy. How? How can we be holy? Do we need extra intelligence? No. Do we need good look? No. Do we need great personality? No. What do we need? What we need is when we know how to love. When we know how to love. Why? Because God is love. God is love. And if love is within us, our desire is always to do something good for the other, because that is love. That is true holiness, to desire what is good for the other. That is true happiness. True happiness. And in the gospel today, Jesus Christ gave us a very specific way. How can we be happy? However, it seems to be that what Jesus told us is opposite of how the world is telling us how to be happy. It seems to be totally opposite. Why? Because Jesus is telling us, if you want to be happy, be poor in spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit. If we want to be truly happy, we shouldn't be preoccupied by worldly wealth, by all these material things that we possess around us, because it will never ever give us satisfaction. Just think about it. If you have money, you have more, you want more. If you have a car, you want a nicer car. You have a house, you want a bigger house. We don't stop wanting. It doesn't want to stop. It means we are never satisfied with what we have. Until we recognize that the infinite desire will stop if we recognize the infinite love of God. That is the only infinite love of God that we have to have in our heart. We cannot be attached with everything that we have. If you will again think about it, have you seen a hearse followed by a mover? I don't think no. We cannot bring everything in our grave. But we can bring love of God and share it others. When we are detached from all this a stage for everything for us to understand. Blessed are the merciful. Mercy came from the word hesed in Hebrew. If we look at the profound meaning of hesed in Hebrew, it means love. It means agape, another biblical term of love. It means that we become compassion came from the Latin word compatior, meaning to say to suffer with. If we enter into the suffering of others, we experience what is truly beautiful, what is truly happy, because that is what Christ did. He came to us, embrace our suffering, our humanity, and if we follow him, that is where we will find true joy and true happiness. And I can guarantee you that. Because you will give hope to someone who is suffering. Blessed are the clean of heart. Purity of heart. Purity of heart. We cannot divide our heart. Our heart is just one heart aiming to see God face to face, further than our response or our song. Only one heart. If you are married, you are only having one heart for your spouse, isn't it? And you give everything in one heart. Your thing, your heart is only for the church, for God, for Christ. Only one heart. Let everything that stays in our heart be removed from our heart, so that this space in our heart can be filled with God's grace. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness. My brothers and sisters in Christ, we should be hungry for right relationship with God, opposed to hunger for bodily pleasure. Always desire this bodily pleasure every day of our lives, temptations left and right. Never be occupied by that. Otherwise, again, no room for true love, no room for true mercy. Our heart will remain divided, and there will be no true happiness. No true happiness. Blessed are the meek and humble. We cannot be always desiring for power and authority. Unfortunately, we see that everywhere in our society. Power, authority, that's all they want. Otherwise, we will not allow the authority of God to reside in our heart. Be humble. Be meek like the Lamb of God. Like our Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to bring home this thought, this beatitude. Continue reflecting the rest of the beatitude. Continue looking for the mercy and love of Christ. Because the beatitude, this should always be our attitude. This will be our behavior. This is our action. This is how to become happy and to become saint. The beatitude is the way to become saved. But this beatitude tells us one challenging thing. And I want us to remember this. And I want to challenge myself and challenge each one of you. The word diminishment. Diminishment. We diminish ourselves. When we diminish ourselves, then we augment our love in Christ. Diminish ourselves. You know, in music, those who play chord, guitar, piano, there is a chord, okay? If you diminish the chord, there's a change in the root of that chord in music. It lowers a half note, two notes in a chord, and it becomes diminished, like C diminished. And it will result to a perfect tone. Perfect tone that will sense of mystery, a sense of beauty in the music. Therefore, we diminish ourselves. If we diminish ourselves, then we allow God to infuse His grace to our very being, to our very life. And because of that, we will produce a perfect tone, a perfect tone that will be so holy, a perfect tone of beauty, a perfect tone of happiness, a perfect tone of holiness. Because we are perfectly belong to God.
As they are a
the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
light and their peace. To us also, your servants, who are those sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, Saint Wenceslaus, and with all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these things good. O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with your life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you. we treasure our greatest of our country. So please pray for our country, pray for our leaders, our country needs mercy and our love. Also, celebration, there will be a cemetery services today, Sunday, November 1st, at noon time. We probably are prepared for that already. Bisley Cemetery, there will be a prayer service. Another service, prayer service, will be at 2 p.m. West Gethsemane at Highway 36. And another one is at 3 p.m. Recon at 2218. And there will be Mass on Monday, November 2nd, 8 a.m. here at the Holy Rosary Church.
Whenever you pray today, please pray for my dad. He's in the hospital. He went to Victoria and now he's in San Antonio. He's going to have a couple of surgeries. He should be fine, but just keep him in your prayers, please. Thank you so much.
Christ.